Welcome to Design Domination, where you'll gain confidence, clarity, and a competitive edge in a crowded marketplace so you can dominate your competition. Hi, and thanks for tuning in. I'm Colleen Grotzer, and in this episode of Design Domination, I'm going to be talking about skip navigation links. Now, if you're new to web accessibility or you find it daunting, then you'll be happy to know that there are some small things you can do when you build websites that have really big impact. And one of them is adding a skip link. It will improve the accessibility and usability of your websites. Now, if you're already building accessible websites, you may have heard about skip links, but maybe you don't know exactly why they're useful or who they're really for. So whichever camp you fall into, I'm going to talk all about skip links today, what they are, who they benefit, how to add one, and how to test your site for one to see if it has it. So first off, what is a skip link? Well, it's a hyperlink that links to another part of the same web page. Usually, we see a skip link in the form of a skip navigation link or a skip to main content link. And individuals that use a keyboard to get around a website use this type of link to skip areas on a website, such as the header and the entire navigation. The header and the navigation are repeated at the top of every page. And so without a skip link, they actually have to go through every single link at the top of the page to get to the main page content. And not only that, they have to do that on every single page. Now, it's not uncommon to also encounter a skip to footer link on websites, which takes you directly to the footer. And this can be beneficial in certain situations. Now, if you're familiar with the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines, or WCAG, you may know that there's a guideline, 2.4.1, that's called bypass blocks. And it says that a mechanism must be available to bypass blocks of content that are repeated on multiple web pages. Okay, now they don't specifically mention a skip link, and so that's not required, but it is the best way to be able to skip blocks of repeated content. Now, a skip link is not used by everyone, and it's helpful for certain individuals, and those people are keyboard users. And there are multiple groups within that. So the first group is sighted keyboard users who prefer to use a mouse or can't use a mouse. And they could be individuals who have a motor disability, maybe they have arthritis, multiple sclerosis, carpal tunnel, or even a broken arm or wrist, right? Because a disability can be temporary too. And another group is sighted users who use an assistive device that interacts with the keyboard, such as a sip and puff device, or a mouth stick, or a head wand. And with a sip and puff system, these individuals can actually use the computer with their mouth, the cheek, the chin, or their tongue. And with a mouth stick, they place the stick in their mouth and they use it to press keys on the keyboard. And then a head wand is used by individuals who tap their head. Now, whether or not they also use an assistive device, sighted keyboard users use the tab key to tab from the top of a web page down through the interactive elements on the page. So hyperlinks, form fields, and buttons, for example. And if the web page does not have a skip navigation link, then they have to tab through every single hyperlink in the navigation and any other hyperlinks that might be in the header. And that's just to get to the main content of the page. So imagine a menu with 5 hyperlinks under the first menu item, and then 5 more under the second menu item, and then maybe 10 more under the next one, and so on, right? That is a lot of hyperlinks to have to tab through. And that is a lot of work for someone to do to get to the content that they're looking for on a web page. And this is not just an inconvenience, like of their time, either, okay? Because it can actually make things uncomfortable or even painful for individuals who have a motor issue or repetitive stress injury. So now imagine what someone using a keyboard along with an assistive device might have to go through to get around a web page without a skip link. Should someone be expected to tap their head 20 times to get to the main page content? Should they have to puff out of their mouth 20 times? I mean, it's definitely not okay to ask people to do this, but yet many websites are requiring this because they don't have a skip link. Now, another group that is served by skip links is screen reader users, and that's because they use the keyboard along with the screen reader. You might be surprised to find out that they are not as inconvenienced by blocks of repeat header hyperlinks as the sighted keyboard users are. And that's because screen reader users are at least able to use keyboard commands to bring up a list of headings or hyperlinks on a page, for example. But that is only helpful for them if those things have actually been added to the page and if they've been formatted properly. Okay, so now let's talk about checking a website to see if the header includes a skip link or not. Well, this is so easy because all you have to do is go put the cursor in the URL field of the browser at the top of the browser window, or put it at the top of the web page, and then hit the tab key until you get onto the page itself, and then tab to the navigation links. And then you can use shift tab to go back to see if there is a skip link prior to the top of the main page content there. Now, if there is a skip link, it usually appears before you tab to the hyperlinked logo, you know, if the logo is hyperlinked, or the navigation or other hyperlinks that might be in the header area. And you should see it once you tab to it. Now, if the website does not have a skip link, it's probably not an accessibility-ready theme, and it likely has other accessibility issues. On the other hand, just because it has a skip link doesn't mean it's a good theme or an accessible theme either. And you can check out my episode on accessibility-ready WordPress themes for more on that. But anyway, if you need to add a skip link, it's actually very simple to do so. And since you want it to be on every single page, you'll want to add it to the header template for the website. And if there's more than one header template file, just add it to all of them. And then, in the HTML code, add a hyperlink that appears toward the beginning of the web page, usually right after the body tag. And then it should be one of the first hyperlinks that someone can tab to on the page. And you know, it's just a line of code. It's a hyperlink that links to the main content area of the web page. So you'll have a href equals and then pound, and then you could have main, and then you could have class equals skip link. And then inside that hyperlink, the hyperlink text would say skip to main content. It could potentially say skip navigation instead. It's just important to make it obvious to the user what that link is for. And then where the main content starts, which could be the main tag, but it could potentially be a div tag, because it depends on the theme setup, there you would add an ID with the exact same name as the anchor in the hyperlink that you just added. So for instance, main ID equals main. You could potentially have a skip link that shows all the time, but this takes up space in the header area, and that's usually limited. And it also isn't necessary for all users, so you can just present it to those who will use it. And this requires some minor CSS work. So in the CSS file, to only visually hide the skip link, you want to add the following code, but you also want to name it the same class that you applied to the skip link hyperlink. Okay, so you would have skip link, and then you would have position absolute, overflow hidden, top auto, left 10,000 pixels, width 1 pixel, height 1 pixel. Okay, and then you'd have another CSS class that is for skip link focused, and that would be top 0, left 0, and then the width and height would be auto. Now, what's crucial is to avoid using visibility hidden or display none, because if you do that, it will actually hide the skip link from all users. And you can style the colors and the exact position and the width however you like, but it is important that the skip link have sufficient contrast with its background once it appears on screen. So the skip link needs to be functional, taking keyboard users to the main content on the page, but also readable by all sighted keyboard users, including those who may have low vision. Now that you know how helpful skip links are to many users, you might be asking yourself if you should add multiple skip links to the websites that you build. And the answer is probably not, although complex sites could potentially benefit from maybe, you know, one more skip link. But remember the sole purpose of a skip link, at least a skip navigation link. And that is for sighted keyboard users to avoid having to tab through repeated hyperlinks in the header. If you add additional skip links to a web page, you're just creating more hyperlinks for those users to have to tab through or puff or tap their head or whatever the situation may be. And that defeats the very purpose of having a skip link to begin with. Plus, remember, it's helpful to understand that screen reader users can use keyboard shortcuts to pull up a list of headings or hyperlinks on a web page, so they can easily jump to other areas of the page that way. But again, that's as long as those headings and hyperlinks have been formatted properly. Now, if you want to find out three other easy things that you can do to make your websites more accessible, attend my free workshop, where I'll teach you this as well as three common mistakes that most web designers and developers make. You can register for the workshop at creative-boost.com/workshop-ready.